Hi, and welcome back to Lesson 3. In this video, I'm going to show you some of the concepts behind a combination chart or combo chart. And then I'll also do a combo chart across multiple sheets. So why is it a big deal to do a combo chart? Let's take a look at this Amazon stock data. In this column, we have the date, open, high, low, close, and the volume of shares sold on that particular day for this stock. So let's say that I want to chart maybe the date. Let's go back to April 1st. And then I want the closing price and the volume. Now these columns aren't right next to each other, so I have to hit the control key. I'm holding the control key down now and then highlighting those values. Now if I go to create a normal chart, insert, charts, oh, let's do a line chart just to show you what I'm talking about. This orange line, this is the volume, and it's in millions. Our closing stock price is down in the thousands. Looks like the closing price varies from 1862 to 1814, and might go over 1900 for a couple days of the month. But that number is so low compared to these millions, that closing price just gets buried here. Looks like it's pretty close to zero. Hence the need for a combination chart. So if I go up and change the chart type to combo, and here are the two series names. One is the closing price, and the other is the volume. By default, it wants to make a clustered column and a line chart. Let me put the closing price on the secondary axis over to the right, and let's see what I get. Make it big. And it looks, here's the dates along the bottom. Over here on the right is the closing price. And that's the blue column chart here. And then the orange line is the volume. So now I can see how the two interact, or if they do at all. I could also make both parts a line chart. Or I could make, you know, one shoot just about anything. I don't know if this is going to make any sense. No, but I could. Not a good idea, but just because I can doesn't mean I should. So I'm going to leave it with two lines here and hit OK. And there we go. And I can do some formatting over here. I could put commas in there, but that's good to go for now. Probably need a different chart title. Let's look at doing approximately the same thing, except doing it across multiple sheets. So I'm going to delete this chart, clicking on it, and then just hitting the delete. So if I want the dates, let's see, hit date and then control shift down arrow. There's all my dates. So there's 255 dates. And then I want the closing price at the same time. So let's see if I hit control close. And then can I hit shift down? Oh, yeah, I can. All right. So now I have those two columns highlighted. Now I'm going to come up here and make a line chart out of that. And make it big enough so I can see it. So I have the closing price for that. And I don't want the word close. I want the word Amazon up here. So there's a few different ways to do it. One is to click on the line itself and see how up in the formula, the title of the chart is up here, Amazon E3. So I'll just change this to cell A1. And hit enter, and now I get Amazon up there as the title, and it's also the name of the series. Okay, so now I have the closing price for Amazon, but I want to put the closing price for Apple over here as well, which is on a separate sheet. How do I get the Apple closing price onto this same thing, even though it's on another sheet? So let me go over here and go to Chart Tools, Design, select data. I want to add a new series, and the series name is going to be this Apple cell A1, and the series values, delete that, and I'm just going to click on all the closing prices over here and drag it down, get to the bottom of it, and hit OK, and hit OK. And now I have my two closing prices. So let's see, let me add a legend Oh, I want it on the bottom. I don't want it on the right. Let's see. Bottom. There we go. So it's hard to tell which stock is doing better over time when they're this far apart. I'd like them to be able to be compared to each other a little easier on this. But unfortunately, the Amazon closing price is up near the 2000s and Apple's is around 200 or so. So how do I get them to be next to each other? Well, I'm going to use a combo chart to do this. So I'm going to change the chart type, hit combo, and I'm going to, there's what it looks like now, ick. I think I'm going to make them both a line chart. And on Apple, I'm going to put on the secondary axis, and now they're next to each other and kind of superimposed over the top of each other. That's what I'm looking for. Hit OK, and there we go. And then if I want to see a trend line on which one's done better over the last year, I can just right-click on each one and say Add Trend Line. And I want to see the equation on the chart. Okay, there's the equation for that trend line. Drag it up out of here. Heck, let me go ahead and make it bold. I could increase the font size if I wanted to. Drag it around a little bit. Now let me do the same for Amazon. Right-click on the blue one. Add a trend line, display the equation on the chart. There's that one. Let's see if I can do the format painter here. Click on that, hit format painter, and then click on this one. Oh yeah, that's what I'm talking about. And now I can see the slope of each line. The Apple stock is negative 0.05, so it's gone down in value over the year. And the Amazon has gone down as well, but not as much, negative 0.02. So this formula here is in the form of y equals mx plus b, if you remember your high school algebra. I'm not sure I do anymore, but I looked it up, so it's got to be right. So I see the axis values are different in format, and I'm not a fan of that, so I'm going to come in here and format the axis. And let's see, where's my labels? There's my number. I want it to be a number. I don't know, zero decimal places. And give me 1,000 separators. And do the same thing over here. Right click, format the axis. Come down here to number, format code, category, number, zero decimal places, and use the 1,000 separators. Hit enter, and there we go. All right, that's enough for this video. Thanks a lot, and go Noles.